Here's a question. Which would you rather have? Big balls or a tiny dick? There are many factors to consider before making this decision. Upon first inclination, one may answer,
"Why, big balls, of course."
Big balls?
Why, big balls, of course. At least with big balls, you may have a normal-sized dick. With a normal dick, you won't be ashamed.
At first glance, this seems like sound logic. The male ego is very, very fragile. Especially when it comes to dicks. A small dick can ruin one's self-esteem and make that person be the butt of many a joke. However, big balls may be just as detrimental. The problem with big balls, your penis looks proportionately smaller. The actual size of the penis may not matter as much as the perception of what people think the penis really looks like. Plus, big balls have the added danger of being a bigger target for the footed wrath of a feminist. Pissed off feminists. When realizing that both los grandes and a tiny pecker leave you with the same appearance, it may be a harder decision to make. Tolkien said it best, out of the frying pan, into the fire. Perception is everything. From the position of a giant, New York City looks small. And an ant would marvel at the grandiosity of a park bench. Or to put it back into the terms of tallywhackers, a giant would laugh at your millimeter Peter, and an ant would run from your giant battering ram. This is not a novel idea.